Who got mad?
Who got mad? We got mad.
We talked about it.
Yeah.
Loriano Astros hitting coach. Dude, you like how, like, I pointed out in the breakdown that the hitting coach, like, steps up and pikes up his pants and, like, goes in that position? Because you see it, but when you realize that he did that before Loriano even came at him, it's like, oh, he really, really invited this.
And that's the only thing that, again, maybe it's the blind optimist in me. Like, any player around the league, any person, anyone around the league will say how unacceptable a coach doing that
They're supposed to be the peacemakers.
I mean, doing the international come here, let's fight sign, hiking up the pants, stepping up.
Do you think that
is
so not
acceptable?
Do you think the Astros coaches and Dusty Baker had got ejected already, and we saw Dusty Baker stick up for his guys with the Joe Kelly stuff and yell at Joe Kelly and get into the name-calling and stuff. Do you think they know these guys are going through hell, their players, so they're trying to be extra, like, have their back and stuff, and it's just kind of a lose-lose all around? Do you think there's any sense of, like, you know, they're babying the players because their life sucks right now?
I think part of taking this job for this year was, like, hey, you're going to have to blindly defend these guys over something you probably don't even want to.
Like, overprotect. They're basically helicopter parents.
And then did you see the Reddit quote after the game?
He's
like, I hope this doesn't put a bigger target on our back. Like, we're already sick of having the big target on our back. And it's like, what?
Well, they don't realize that.
I know.
I feel bad because I don't think they realize that. And I think Astros fans don't realize, like, you've lost the benefit of the doubt. Teams are allowed to be mad at you.
Yeah.
And then when you hit them, be it by accident because it's a rookie pitcher doesn't have his stuff, or on purpose, but even if it's accidental, like, the fire's lit already. And I think Astros fans are forgetting that. They're hoping that everyone just forgets and, like, gives us a fresh start. It's like, no, the entire league is granted one season minimum where that fire starts the minute you come to their stadium, and any slight action, the flames will grow. You know what I mean? Like, we're not at slate zero. And that's what the Astros fans, and I think the Astros want everyone to be at. Like, can we just forget it and put it the past? No! Everyone gets one season minimum to be fucking mad at you guys.
And that's the whole problem with them not actually getting punished. If they had a postseason banner, if they had something that affected these guys, then I think there would be less of a fire. I think that, you know, think about what happens yesterday. If Loriano goes to first and the Astros are banned from the postseason this year, which imagine how many guys would have just opted out for them. It's been pretty hilarious. Like, you know, that just probably ends up with Loriano saying, see you in October.
Yeah.
See you in October. But they didn't get a punishment. So now the players feel like they have to be part of it.
Yeah.
So go check it out. Check out John Boy.
The breakdown.
Breakdowns.
It's a mess. The West is a mess besides the A's, who look so damn good.
Yeah.
They're 9-1 in their last 10 games, 9-0 in their last 9 games. They're going to lose Loriano for probably a month.
A while.
If Joe Kelly got suspended for 8 games, what's Loriano's going to be, 15?
It's going to be interesting. Joe Kelly has his appeal today, which is funny because he can just, like, point at Loriano and be like, look at that. What do you think about that? And the bigger thing is, I mean, it's, we don't even think about it really, but it's the COVID stuff. I mean, MLB,
they said you can't do that. So it's going to be bad.
It'll be really interesting because it's the abbreviated season. And when you think of Joe Kelly's suspension, it kind of goes back to, like, he's a reliever. Like, in those 8 games, you know, that's, even if he pitches as maximum, that's like 4 innings of baseball. So we'll see how they treat it with Loriano. I think it's going to be big.
What do you think? 20?
No, I kind of like the 15 number. I wouldn't be surprised. I could see them doing less. I could see them maybe doing 12 and landing at 10 with the appeal or something like that. Because, man, Loriano's a really good ball player, and he's a big part of that team. And he gets baited in by a coach. He got hit twice in that game with a baseball. That doesn't feel good. And I went on one of these rants on Wake and Jake this morning. But, dude, think about, like, the Myles Garrett situation in the NFL. Like, he tries to attack someone with his helmet. And we always say heat of the moment in sports. and it's clearly the heat of the moment. A guy gets hit with two baseballs, and then he gets baited in by a coach. Like, yeah. I think that will play a factor. Laureano, you can't go running in there.
You can't run there, though. I mean,
I think it's
more that the coach should also get in trouble than it should lessen what Laureano did.
I'd like to see 12, and then I think you maybe get an appeal to 10, and I think that kind of ends up fair. Could I see it being more significant? Absolutely.
I think they're going to lay down that. I think they don't want this to happen again. In COVID seasons, the optics are so bad that they may lay down like hammer here.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't be shocked if they go 20, if they go a full month.
I could see it.
Like they may want to set a precedent as hard as they could possibly set. But Cintron or whatever, did you hear a lot of other players coming out and saying, yeah, that guy sucks? Like,
adds up.
He should get in trouble. Dude, Laureano, and this is what Astros fans are getting upset about. He didn't need to give the sarcastic pitching lesson to the young player. Of course he didn't need to. But he's allowed to, and
gives
it's
a crap about it, that.
And it's like,
that's hilarious.
It's funny. And he was doing it in a mocking, joking way because he got hit twice by the same dude, and it doesn't feel good to get hit.
Who's not a big-time major leaguer either.
No, he doesn't.
So that's Laureano twisting the knife.
Yeah, so
which is beautiful.
So he's being, you know, a jerk. But he's deservedly so.
Yes.
Very much allowed, because that's what all the Astros are saying. Like, he didn't have to mock him and give the pitching lesson. Of course he didn't have to. But he got hit twice and he's upset.
He didn't have to get hit twice.
And he didn't charge the mound. He didn't yell or scream. All he did was casually just, like, make some jokes and poke fun at how that dude sucks at pitching.
It was perfect. If you're complaining about that, get out of here.
Oh, that's the biggest. Like, that's what the Astros announcers were saying. That's what Astros fans are saying.
Until they saw the coach yelling that. That was pretty good, that exhale you highlighted.
That announcer is like liking all the tweets that are saying he's a trash announcer.
Yeah.
So there's two announcers. I don't know who's for the Astros, but I mean, I have the audio. The one guy is going all in. I'm like, he can't be mocking the pitcher. He can't be doing that. And for Laureano to start this because he got hit with a backdoor slider. And I don't know the Astros announcers, but he was going all in. And the second guy, when he sees the coach bait him in, he just has this like, oh, it's us again.
Yeah.
Like, oh, it was, we're going to be the bad one again here.
Top down.
So Jeff Bloom is the color guy. So I don't know if he's an ex-player. I don't know who Jeff Bloom
is. Yeah, he is.
So I think it's, to me, I read it that Jeff Bloom was embarrassed by what the play-by-play guy was saying because he's a player and actually knows what's happening.
Yeah.
And then what Jeff Bloom just lets out that, well, it's so funny.
Yeah.
Because he's like,
just exhausting.
We're the bad guys again.
And that's what happens when you have a top-down, poorly run organization with no rules, and then you don't really punish them.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it again, kind of one of those good, bad highlights of the sport. It was fun when it kicked off last night. But, the A's are rolling, more importantly. The Astros dropped to 6-9 on the year. Nice. The A's, they were winning games without their dudes playing well. And now the mats are going off. Simeon's finding it. Like, that team is going. We'll see the Laureano suspension. They do have bodies that can kind of help replace it. But he bats second for them. He's got a .400 on base. Like, Laureano's a ball player, dude. So, very interested to see how the suspension comes down.
Can you imagine if there was fans in the crowds for this Astros? The season already feels like turmoil from then. They go Dodgers.
It's fans on the field.
Whole big thing. You go to Houston or talk better, Jimmy.
Okay.
Go to Oakland and it's this whole big thing, you know, like they are getting the turmoil that we thought they were going to get. But imagine if there was fans and like outside the bullpen, like
brawls, man.
Yeah.
Have
that's why I think it, because right now it seems like this isn't going to stop. And they didn't even get to play the East or the Central. They're only playing the West. Like, so that's why I think MLB might come down like ridiculously hard here.
We'll see. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised at all, but I do think they have to take an effect, you know, the shortened season in an everyday player.
Mm-hmm.
Joe Kelly's one inning out of the bullpen every other day if you're doing it right.